At this time, it is our pleasure to present the final performance, East Liverpool High School's performance of Shrek, the musical.
Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek, who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy, because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, the little ogre parents sat him down to talk, just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly. Growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're 7.
Now you're 7. So it's time to go away. Take some words of wisdom for your trip.
These are little things you need to know.
When you are grotesque, life is Kafkaesque.
Just keep walking.
Just keep walking.
And you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true, but not for you. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. And just around the bend, there's a friend or two, but not for you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Watch out for men with pitchforks.
Oh, I know it's sad, very sad, but ogres are used to that. The hardships, the indignities, the endless, endless streams of misery.
Hello, sorry I'm late. Welcome to Fiona the Musical. Yay, let's talk about me. Once upon a time, there was a little princess named Fiona who lived in a kingdom far, far away. One fateful day, her parents told her that it was time for her to be locked away in a desolate tower, guarded by a fire-breathing dragon, as so many princesses had for hundreds of years before.
Your mama packed a dolly for your trip.
Your papa packed your boots and bubble gum.
Darling, don't be sad, a tower's not so bad.
Just keep waiting.
Just keep waiting. And someday your prince will come.
Isn't that the saddest thing you've ever heard? A poor little princess hidden away from the world, high in a tower, awaiting her one true love.
Sorry about the technical hitch. Cue the happy villagers.
Enjoy the fun. We saved you a spot, and we've got a lot to
go, wee laddie.
And so the little ogre found a perfectly rancid swamp. And whenever a crowd came along to burn at the stake, he knew exactly what to do.
Roar! Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway, doing what I can with the one-man conga line. Yeah, your big, bright, beautiful world is all teddy bears and unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and stuff it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this. It's not that complicated. Sure, I'm fated to be lonely, and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say it's why I was created, but I don't care. 'Cause being liked is grossly overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I've got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine. All alone, it's mine, and it's mine.
Mud, you'll get used to it.
This place is a dump.
It's not fit for a pig.
Hello?
He can hear you.
We are standing right here.
Look, you all read Lord Folklunch's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures are banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All fruitcakes and freaks will be sent to a resettlement facility.
This place smells like bum.
All right, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio the puppet. That's your patch of mud down there. Fairy godmother?
Right here.
Ugly duckling?
Quack, quack. Dumped on a swamp. Man, I tell ya, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks puns. Life is disappointing. Wow is what I know. Out it by my nose. That's just how it goes.
Bears, take your spot over there by Pinocchio. Too close. Too far. Ah, just right.
Strife is never ending.
Sugar Plum Fairy? Wicked Witch?
They drag me from the pond.
They blew our condos down.
Mama's in distress.
They ridiculed my hat.
They said that we were fat.
They tore my cotton granny dress and called me a hot and tranny mess.
Humpty Dumpty.
Story of my life. Booted from the ball. The party's off the hook.
But I'm too left alone.
That's the story of my life.
All right, and if we find you back in the fairy tale kingdom, You'll be executed!
That's the story of my life. I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending.
And it's right here, not how it goes.
I always dreamed I'd get an ever after. If this is it, it blows, it blows, it blows. Story of my life, always double cross, always in the woods, always getting lost. Always on the road, always up a creek, always kicked around and treated like a friend. That's the story of my life, yes sir. That's the story of my life, oy vey. That's the story of my life.
Oh crap!
What are you doing in my car?
Oh gosh, we were forced to come here!
Forced by who?
Lord Farquaad. He hoofed and he poofed and he signed an eviction notice.
Well, that's not my problem. Now you all need to get off my land and back from where you came!
Go back? We can't go back.
Farquaad will turn us into bratwurst.
The guy is bad news.
Hey!
Maybe you could talk to him.
Yeah, you can talk to him because you're big and scary and he'll listen to you.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp and avoid large crowds. Or haven't you heard the stories?
You mean the stories that say I'm a big bad wolf?
And the ones that say I'm a wicked witch?
How about the ones that say I'm a wooden boy? What? I'm not a wooden boy! I have a glandular condition.
Look here, Ogre, I'm gonna spell it out for you. We don't want us here any more than you do, but you're the only one tough enough to stand up to that no good flim flammer Farquaad.
Tough enough? You don't even know me.
I always dreamed I'd get a happy ending.
It was foretold in my horoscope.
Can't you help us out with an ever after?
Can't you see that you're our only hope? You're our only hope. You're our only hope. You're our only hope.
Esperanza.
Okay. Okay. Attention all fairy tale things. Your welcome is officially worn off. I'm going to go see this Farquaad guy right now and get you all off my land and back from where you came.
Yeah! Time to say goodbye, time to say farewell. Time for you to fly, it's been really swell. Gosh, I'm gonna cry, time to say goodbye.
I will be right back.
Time to save a moose.
Don't get comfortable.
Ogre on the loose.
And please don't touch any of my things.
Time to say goodbye.
Don't die.
Dangling the map. I'm all turned around. Duloc? Yeah, okay. Swamp? Good.
Ah! Hey, watch where you're going, Mary Poppins. I'm okay. All right, you just stay right there. That's a lesson right there. Donkeys should not be climbing trees. But I had to do something to shake those goons. I guess it worked out, because,
Hey, I hear something! Over there!
Uh-oh. Help a donkey out, would you?
It's hideous!
Now that's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Move out the way, ogre, and let us out of
him. Why? What did he do?
He's a talking...
I don't want to die, I don't want to die, I don't want to die!
He's a talking donkey, a freak of nature. As are you, you unsavory beast.
Now you're going the right way for a smack bottom.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'm required to place you both under arrest.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away. And don't come back!
Man, can I just say, that was incredible! You had them tripping all over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Oh, good. I'm glad. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Oh, what a shocker.
Say, you lost or something?
No, I'm just trying to figure out the best route to...
Oh, Duloc. I know Duloc. You gotta let me go with you, because I'm like a GPS with fur.
I will be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own. Now you look like us. Hey, didn't you hear? Man, this place is going Stepford. We need to join forces. Or else they're gonna lock me back under my cage. And I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I told you this, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata. Whoa, that was really scary. And can I just say, if that don't work, your brother certainly do the trick.
Look at me, donkey. What am I? No, I'm an ogre. You know, grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really?
Oh.
Hey, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Shrek, huh? You know what I like about you, Shrek? You got the whole, I don't care what anybody thinks of me thing. I like that. I respect that, Shrek. You all right.
Oh, good. I'm glad. Goodbye.
Hey, 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 you gotta let me go with you. You don't know what it's like to be considered a freak. Well, maybe you do. That's why we gotta stick together.
Donkey.
No, 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 don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Tear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be a friend. Others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with the moping. Your pal, my calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back when things get scary. And I'll shave it when it gets hairy. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You need me. I'll treat you right. You never act shoddy. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. What do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. You need me. You and me, we belong together. Like butter and grits, like jewels and bits, like yin and yang, sturm and drang, like ing and tang, attached at the hip, but not like an old lady hip that might break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid on cake. Like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey, we'll sit together like that Velcro stuff. You be the pussy side, I'll be the spiky. Like those funny things that kids wear, you know, feeties. We'll go together like donuts and we'll go for donuts. Donuts and diabetes. You need me. You need me.
I hear something! Over there!
Ah! I need you. I need you, don't let me go.
Okay, look. Only because I'm lost, you can come.
All right.
On one condition. You keep the jabbering to a minimum.
You got it. No talking. Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
That's what I'm talking about. Shrink and Donkey. Two Star War friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Farquaad is on his way. He's on his way. He is nearly here. Down the hall, getting close. He is just outside. Beyond the door, he is on his way.
Gingerbread man.
Look what you've done to my leg. You're a monster.
I'm not the monster. Here you are. You and the rest of that fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not the kingdom because you're not the king.
Oh, but I will be just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me.
That's it! My patience has reached its end! I've had enough to hear with you creatures!
Okay, maybe I have heard tell of a princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man, who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man!
Can I go now?
You still haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You will.
I won't.
You will or I'll.
No!
Then tell me where she is.
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day's walk from here, in a dragon-guarded castle surrounded by hot, boiling lava.
Ooh, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except that whole dragon and lava thing, I'll have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise.
Captain, round up your men, summon the citizens, and bring the cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's the things I get?
Thelonious, tell the royal copier I need to get my hair pressed. We're going to get a queen!
You'll get a queen. He has a plan. Someone will go against their will, they will fetch a queen. We'll draw a name, what a plan. He has it can't fail. Good plan.
Horse or a cut along the road. Punch buggy!
Ow!
Fun, right?
No, what kind of insane game
vacation is this?
Haven't you ever been on a road trip?
No.
Man, you really need to get out more because... Punch buggy!
Ow! Donkey!
I got you with that money card over there.
If you do that one more time...
See, that's another reason you need me around. Who else is going to fill you in on all the fun stuff you missed out on? Man, you may not know it, but you're a unlucky ogre to meet up with a...
Punch buggy! Mutton cart at 3 o'clock.
Mother Hubbard, that hurt.
You know what? You're all right. This is fun. Want to play again?
No, I'm all right. You win. Can we move on to I Spy or I Went on a Picnic or something that's not going to put me in a body cast?
Hey, Donkey, look. Lord Farquaad's castle.
Didn't I tell you I'd find it?
It's a bit much, don't you think? You think he might be compensating for something? Oh, never mind.
Welcome to the Duloc Fetch a Princess Festival. The show's about to begin.
Hey, you!
Oh, why?
Let's find this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop at the gift shop and get a t-shirt.
We're not shopping for t-shirts.
What a terrific surprise! Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner. I had them all arrested. Hey, naughty, 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 no. If you had a quirk, you didn't pass inspection. We all have our standards, but I will have perfection. And so, things are looking up here in Duloc.
Just take a look.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes to cook.
A model that amazes, a plan with 7 phases. Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up
in Duloc. The ladies all look swell. The men are so dashing. Thanks to my new dress code, the fashion's never clashing. Hey, naughty, naughty, naughty now. This castle I had built is taller than the cliff tops. A city like a postcard with a monorail and gift shops. And so. No one from the gutter in Duloc.
He's taking aim.
Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
They're all the same.
The upshot is enormous. When you can shout,
conformist!
Yes, things are looking up. Here in Duloc, hey, let's hear it for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific, huh? Wham! Wham! Come on! Boys! There's no sign of slowing. We're growing We're growing. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up.
Things are looking up here in Duloc.
Oh.
Here in Duloc.
Oh.
Up, 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 up. Maestro, and now, good people of Duloc, the moment you've all been waiting for, the raffle drawing to determine who will set forth on the great and noble quest to rescue the Princess Fiona from the dragon's fiery keep. Spin the barrel!
Excuse me. Roar? Are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear into your heart?
No, but this little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yes, where you dumped all those fairy tale creatures.
Newsflash, ogre, that oozing mud pit falls from the province of Duloc, and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Now look here, half pint.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, this is perfect!
What is?
You! You're big and hulking and wonderfully expendable. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Congratulations, Ogre! You've won the prize of setting forth on a great and noble quest.
But we're already going on a quest.
Right, to get my swamp back.
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. Just one more little task, and I'll hand over the deed to your swamp.
And what is this little task?
Oh, Walter, the dossier on Her Royal Highness. Things are looking up.
Things are looking up. Things are looking up. Here in Duloc.
And no one's gonna bring me down.
That was odd.
Not as odd as you agreed to going on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
I've read the stories.
Yeah, and I've read the sports pages. That'll make me no hockey player.
Oh, come on. Dragon, tower, how hard can it really be?
I bet we're gonna find out, I'll tell you that. Hey, what does it say about this princess anyway?
Well, apparently she likes Tex-Mex, long walks on the beach, and lazy Sundays.
Ooh, she sounds fun. What else?
She's been locked in a dragon-guarded tower since he was 7 years old.
Oh, that is so sad. All alone since she was 7 years old, 7 years old, 7 years old.
You are so weird.
There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, a torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she was dead. Skip ahead, but in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, 'cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my wine night, and esteem will look just like these pictures. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Day number 23. I know it's today. I know it's today.
Here's a good one. It's a classic.
There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box, how I wonder does she pee? Blah, 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 poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, been there, red, that seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, but in the end the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear, and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth and manly hooves. He'll propose on one knee, and our prenup will be binding. About time we set a wedding date. Day number 958. I know it's today. He'll show up today. Princess, any princess, take your pick, they're all like me. Not exactly, I'm still waiting. They're both living happily ever after. Better get here, I want to love in seconds flat. No one needs these metal bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping. Cut this fairy tale, cut the peril in the pitfalls, cut the puppet and the whale, cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses, and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. But I know he'll appear, though I seem a bit older, and I'm a vandal now as well. Hope he won't mind. I'm a catch and a very gifted boulder. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Day number. Are you there, God? It's me, Fiona. It's me, Fiona. Now I know he'll appear. There are rules and there are
get it, Shrek. Why don't you just make Farquaad give you the swamp back? You know, throttle him, lace these to his fortress, the whole trip.
For your information, there are a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example,
okay. Ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes. No.
They make you cry?
No.
Oh, you leave my son to get all brown and start sprawling little white hairs?
No, layers. You know, ogres have layers. Onions have layers. Ogres have layers. You get it? We both have layers.
Oh, we both have layers. But not everybody like onions. Parfaits. Everybody love parfaits. And they have layers. Fur, have you ever met a person say, hey, let's go get some parfaits. And they say, heck no, I don't want no parfaits. Parfaits are the most delicious thing on the whole planet.
I don't care. Ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits are so delicious.
This may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
I got a remedy for that.
No, I am not interested.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere, 'cause the fun is getting there. Oh, what the heck, I gotta say, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail, forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you've made strides with me. And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, it just makes the time go by faster.
Why me? Why me? Tell me, what was my crime?
We are strolling.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots. Never mind, that's just Dakota Heights.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine. Won't someone please send me a sign? What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Oh, you see that little bunny?
Aye, it looks delicious.
Sing a song, it's the trail, it's the way to get around. Before you know it, you can ground with me.
What
and I know all I need all along is a path and a bell and a song. So I'm singing lo-dee-do and I'm howling see-do with you. You feel that heat?
Aye.
It just came up so suddenly.
That would be because we're on a bridge.
Oh, I didn't even notice. What bridge is this?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Oh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. So that intense heat I'm feeling coming up under my hooves right now?
That would be the Lake of Molten Lava.
Oh, the Lake of Molten Lava!
Oh, donkey.
We're over a rickety bridge over a lake of molten lava!
For Pete's sake, just keep walking, and whatever you do, don't look down.
I'm looking down, Shrek! I'm looking down!
Just take a step.
I can't.
Look in my eyes.
I can't.
Take my hand.
Okay, but don't let me go. Don't let me go.
I won't let you go.
I do to deserve you, my pal, evermore? We crossed the bridge together. What a beautiful metaphor. So I'm singing, and I'm paddling, and I'm traveling with you.
That'll do, donkey. That'll do.
Warn somebody before you just pop one up. My mouth was open and everything.
Believe me, donkey, if that was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Don't be talking this to brimstone. I know what I smell, and it wasn't no brimstone. It ain't come from no stone either.
Hey, look at this. Hope it's fireproof. All right, now you wait here. I'll be right back.
Wait here? You mean, by myself?
Unless you'd rather come rescue a princess and slay a dragon.
No, that's all right. Waiting's fine. Hey, but hurry back! Man, this place is creepy!
You know what happened?
Hey, it's a new guy! We haven't had a new guy in a couple of years!
Oh, God!
You don't want to wake her up.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
She gets really mad.
What? Who are you people? Who are you talking about?
We're nice. Came here to rescue the princess. Just like you.
None of us made it, though.
And we're the lucky ones. She incinerated everyone else.
She keeps us around because we've seen backup.
What? I'm out of here.
That's what we thought.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
That's what we did.
Dragon!
That's what we said.
Another day inside my keep. I get no rest, I get no sleep. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around. I draw my shades and lock my door. Still you come for what ain't yours. Like a hound dog all on fours, you sniff around and around.
Forever, but that sounds like a long time.
Forever.
And I got a hair appointment, you know.
Another night, another name. All in all, you're all the same. Foolish moth, you got the flame to fly around. Siren calls you from her beach. Pretty girl, that perfect peach. She is always
to say here. First of all, I am not a knight. I'm a donkey. And if you can't see that, well, then you need to get your eyes checked. Secondly, that princess is not even my type. And do you know why? I like a big, big girl. I like a big, big girl.
Eli.
a big, big girl.
And as for you, I think you're bluffing, stomping around the hall, huffing and puffing. You want true love, stop with the hating.
Come check your heart.
Well, I hope you've learned something valuable today. Now, if you don't mind, I'll be on my way.
I'm no princess, but he wants me.
What?
No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever.
On me specifically now.
I'm gonna love you forever. You're gonna stay with me forevermore. You're gonna
up there. Shouldn't you toss down some hair or something? Oh, man. I should have worn my cup. Oh, great. I got a snoozer. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. Awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
That's nice. Now, let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight. I have long awaited this day. And I would first like to knowest the name of my champion.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek, I pray that you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Oh, thank you. So, where's the door?
There is no door.
What do you mean there's no door? How do we get down?
Why, the same way you got up.
The same way I got up? Really? You sure? You're kidding, right? Oh, fine, let's go.
Now hold us on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Oh, geez, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
This is how a dream comes true. This is how I pictured you. Climbing in to rescue me. This was always meant to be.
Aw, that's sweet. Now hop on.
This is how the scene must go. You're standing there, the light just so. Then you smile and gaze at me. Take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee.
Whoa.
Sorry. And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true.
Shrek!
What are you doing?
I have to go save my ass.
Thank you. lights float down a bit. Shorten girls are delicate. I've hoped for this my whole life long. Now you're doing it all wrong. Down a robust steed awaits. That's what every story states. Riding over rough terrain, past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
What?
Hey, get back! You did not have permission to touch
Donkey!
Her.
Donkey!
Dragon! Just relax and take a breath. Hope he doesn't burn to death. Never mind the protocol. He's your hero. Champion, my savior, my dashing Romeo. He has a talking donkey. That part I didn't know. Wait a minute, look. It's just like in a book. Fighting over me, as it's meant to be. No more tower in the sky. Slay the dragon and goodbye. Oh my god, we're gonna die!
Get back!
I'm gonna love you forever. How I pictured it. More or less, I must admit, a thumping in my heart, a life about to start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way. At last, my dream comes true. I knew it would be.
Alright, I hope you heard that. She called me a noble steed. She thinks I'm a noble steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
And why not?
Because I have helmet hair.
Please, I wouldest look upon the face of my rescuer.
Oh, but no, you wouldn't, stis.
But how will you kiss me?
Kiss you? That wasn't in the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight, and then they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think that Shrek is your true?
What is so funny?
Let's just say I'm not your type, okay?
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now remove your helmet.
Look, I really don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I don't think I'm going
to. Take it off.
No!
Now!
Ah! Okay.
You're an ogre?
Aw, were you expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh no, I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not some ogre and his pet.
Watch it.
Well, so much for noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, I'm just bringing you back to Lord Farquaad, okay? He's the one who wants to marry you.
Oh,
Then why didn't he come rescue me?
I don't know. You can ask him when we get there tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I need to make camp.
But you've just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
Oh, that's sad, because we're gonna keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now.
Okay, easy. There is a cave right over there.
Shrek, that is no place for a princess.
No, no, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
You want me to read you a bedtime story? Because I will.
I said good night.
She seems nice.
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form.
And this is when I realized, if we could defeat a dragon, then we could do anything. I mean, maybe I could be a steed, or I could even work the crusade circuit if I wanted to. I could even be one of those horses that pull those wagons full of beer. I'll need to get some extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. Who would you be?
I wouldn't be anyone.
But just for fun, though, who would you pick?
I wouldn't.
Like if somebody had a knife out to your throat and was like, look, you can't be Nogi anymore, then who would you pick?
That guy up and hurl him into a tree.
You are no fun at all, you know it? This one is going to be like after we're done rescuing the princess, us alone in our swamp doing nothing all day?
Our swamp? Look, there is no us, there is no we. There's just me and my swamp. And when I do get back, the first thing I'm going to do is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep just then. What's your problem anyway? What you got against the whole world?
I'm not the one with the problem, okay? It's the whole world. You saw how that princess reacted. It's always been that way. They take one look at me and it's, a big, stupid, ugly ogre. They judge me before they know me. That's why I live alone.
But you know what? When we met, I didn't think you were just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Yeah, I know.
So there's really nobody else you'd rather be?
I guess I'd be a hero with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. Or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story. One that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it. The stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn. An ogre always hides, an ogre's fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stand and stare, we'd speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny. I'd have a hero's ending. A perfect happy ending. That's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world. But not for me.
An ogre always hides. An ogre's fate is known.
An ogre always stays in the dark.
You're all alone.
All alone.
And I know.
So yes, I'd be a hero. And if my wish were granted, life would be enchanted.
You need a bow. My calendar's so thin.
To save a hot house
to me
and carry her away.
A perfect happy ending. That's how it should be.
Thank you.
here, lady.
Princess, by any chance, did you eat any of those funny little mushrooms down by the stream?
Of course not. I'm just happy that it's a new day full of promise and fresh starts. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. We obviously got off on the wrong foot, and I'd like to make it up to you.
You would?
Yes. You did rescue me, after all. So I've gathered a basket of berries for the trip, and I made you each a daisy chain.
Oh, look at these! They're beautiful, Princess! Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
You're gonna love them. I promise. Lead the way.
So, Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And what if I do?
Oh, I don't know. German-fested vermin. Princess, not exactly what I expected.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge people before you get to know them. So? Tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Let me put it this way. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yeah. But he is a little intimidated.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What are you guys doing?
What? I'm just saying, you might want to lower your expectations a little bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
Right, a lifetime of misery. Okay.
You chuckled?
Hmm?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Did I?
Yes.
Look, I'm sure it was very difficult living in a dragon-guarded tower and all.
It was.
I'm sure.
All right, then.
But at least you had a roof over your head and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
What? I'm just saying, you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
What? Did you run out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles, I had only bare essentials, army cut, a hot plate and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it, no choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation, out one window, isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I've sat and waited, I'm very dedicated, on the walls these days were added, luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat, I think I've got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I've got you beat, I think I've got you beat.
Aw, that's a sad story, but I've heard better, I'm just saying. A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my britches. See the scorches, you're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? So, I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
No warm cards,
no Christmas cards,
and every day
it was hell on earth day. My dad and mom sent me away. It was my birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve.
Oh.
No warm regards.
No Christmas cards.
No choice, I had no toilet.
And every day was hell on earth.
In my bedroom and very little. 20 years I've sat and waited. I am very dedicated. All the walls are being eradicated.
It was my birthday.
20 years.
I missed my prom. My dad and mom sent me away.
So.
So.
I think I got you beat.
I think I got you beat.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah,
yeah.
I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah,
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 yeah, yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah. Oh well, better out than in, I always say.
Thank you.
494. 495. 496. Princess Fiona, I am Lord Farquaad. What do you think? You're right. Too formal. 600. Fiona, hi, Farquaad. But you can call me Maximus, as I have no doubt you will. Woof. No, too smutty. But soft, what light through yonder window breaks, for it is Fiona, and Farquaad is the sun.
My lord, we have just gotten word. Fiona has been rescued. She's on her way to the castle as we speak.
On her way? Rah, she's on her way, and so am I. I always said I'd be king, and now look, the last adorable piece to my master plan. Ooh, that reminds me. How are the wedding preparations coming?
All in order, my lord. We booked the cathedral and the boy band.
Oh, yes.
Although I did wonder maybe if you wanted to invite your father.
My what?
Your father, my lord.
That horrible little man that kept me down all my life? That mild-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Blackie, please. He couldn't accept the fact I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds, a life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho, and off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, daddy's bed was lumpy, so mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 20 mattresses she slept upon. One night she rolled over, and mama was gone. So daddy was grumpy. Me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt. A bitter, distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me good as dead. Now he lives in squalor, sleeping seven to a bed. You abandoned me in the woods, Daddy. Well, I crawled up and out. And if only you could see me now, Daddy, I'd invite you to the wedding. But you have to be this tall to get in. To the races, men! My bride-to-be is gorgeous, her wedding dress designer. The guest list will be major without a minor minor. Of royal lackeys playing violin.
Strings of royal underling.
Who will not let you in? Aha, aha, aha. Tricked out carriage.
Tricked out carriage.
20 stallions.
20 stallions.
With the coachman named Raoul.
Raoul.
Big reception.
Big reception.
With the boy band,
boy
and
band.
The royal DJ by the pool. Yes, I can see my future, and so it shall be done. It's total domination. with some torture just for fun. Cause I will have perfection and I will have a queen. Once I get that crown on, you will get the guillotine. And I promise you, Daddy, cause I'm all grown up and bigger than you'll ever know, you're gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I'm off to work. Hi-ho.
Na 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 na.
Chicka chicka wonk, chicka chicka wonk wonk.
Chicka wonk wonk, chicka wonk wonk, chicka wonk. Ooh. I'm sorry. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Ooh, we're here.
Oh, would you look at that?
What?
It's Duloc.
Oh, Duloc. I didn't realize we were so close.
No, me either.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
Yes, it does.
So much for that batch of Snuthers I was going to make us.
Snuthers?
Traditional ogre campfire snack. A little bit like s'mores, but instead of chocolate and marshmallows, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Oh, they just melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down for a minute.
No, no sitting down. We need to get the princess back to Duloc.
No. Why? I mean, Duloc can wait till morning.
Morning?
I've spent my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
All right, I'll go get the snacks.
I'll go get the firewood.
Oops, I'm sorry.
Should we just...
I'll just go the other way.
Go
together?
Sure.
One, two, three, four. There's something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. The nervous laugh when she brushes the skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With the giggle and the flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making Google eyes over their food, they need my help, here is setting the mood. Oh, you don't think love is blind? Well, I got some friends that'll think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination.
Three blind mice.
Watch your step, girls.
Three blind mice. See how they run.
You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta put up the pan, you gotta make a move and don't be afraid. Reach for her hand, maybe give her a kiss. She's waiting for a move to be made. So you
gotta.
You gotta make a move. Yeah!
These Snuthers sure are good.
Didn't I tell you? And a little nutty, right?
They're delicious. I guess I'll be dining a little differently tomorrow night.
That's okay. I'll make all kinds of ogre campfire snacks when you come back. Fish-eyed soup. Snake Eye Totar, you name it.
I like that.
Shrek, I know you can hear me right now. But if you could, I'd like to say a few thanks to you. You see, I am in your corner, buddy. But you've got to tell this girl what you're feeling really deep down. You may not get another chance. So go on now. Open up your heart, eh?
Princess?
Yes,
ooh, he's gonna
Shrek.
Tell her.
I was wondering.
Spit out!
Are you going to eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You gotta make a move. You gotta shift in the gear. You gotta buckle down and give it a whirl. The citizen right out of a book with a sunset and a beautiful girl. So you
gotta.
Gotta
make a move now.
gotta make a move, come on.
You gotta make a move now, baby.
You gotta make a move, come on. Can we try it again? Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. You gotta make a move, come on. You gotta make a move, come on. Oh, God. Okay. Sorry, I was just caught up in the magic of the night. Those fireflies, that beautiful sunset.
Sunset. Oh, my gosh, it's almost sunset. I mean, it's late. It's very late.
I get it. You're afraid of the dark, aren't you, Princess?
Yes, yes, that's it. I'm terrified, so I'd better get going.
That's all right. I remember when I was afraid of the dark, too, and... I'm still afraid of the dark.
I'm sorry, but I have to go.
It's okay.
Good night.
Good night.
Nuh-uh. No, sir. I did not travel all this way dealing with you and your body odor just to sit here and let you let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
Hey, I'm an animal, and we've got instincts. And you two were obviously digging each other back there.
Look, I'm just bringing her back to Farquaad, okay?
Mm-hmm. So you don't have any feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, and I'm not saying I do, because I don't, she's a princess, and I'm...
An ogre?
Yes, an ogre.
She needs to know.
Where are you going?
To get more wood before your fire dies. Princess! Princess Fiona! Princess, where are you? Princess, it's scary in here. I ain't playing no games. Shrek!
Donkey, it's okay! Ah! Donkey, it's okay!
What did you do with the princess?
Donkey, I am the princess. It's me in this body.
Oh my God, you ate the princess! Can you hear me? I'll get you out of there, I promise.
Donkey!
Princess? What happened to you?
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form.
Oh, that is so beautiful. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. So now every night when I go to bed, I become this horrible, ugly beast.
All right, calm down. You're not that ugly. Okay, you are ugly, but you're only like this right now. Shrek's like this 24/7. Wait a minute. This is perfect.
Perfect? Donkey, if Lord Farquaad finds out I look like this, he'll never marry me.
So?
So I have to kiss my true love. It's the only thing that will break this spell and make me beautiful.
Well, you know, you're kind of an ogre, and Shrek, well, you got a lot in common.
Shrek?
Yeah, I think if he knew all this, then maybe
No, he can't know. He must ever know, and you cannot tell him. Promise you won't tell. Promise.
All right, I won't tell. But you should. Man, when this is over, I think I'm going to need a lot of serious therapy.
So, Princess, how's it going, first of all? Good? Yeah, good for me, too. I picked this flower right over there is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you because it's pretty. Is what I'm trying to say. And you are also pretty. And I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and a stem, which represent my feelings and tell you how. Oh man, I'm in trouble. When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, How will she know how I feel when words fail? Will I fail too? Hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon because it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing, I'm on the hefty side myself. I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... Oh man, where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail to do? I have a snowball's chance. Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my life stuck in the mud. Now I'm crawling out on a limb. If words fail, she'll understand. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. She sees me like no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
I can't think about Shrek. Not now. I'm a princess after all, and look at me. I mean, really, who could ever love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever is to marry my one true love. Good morning, dawn. Good morning, day. Good morning, morning, dawn. I had a long and sleepless night pondering true love. My fairy tale I know so well has somehow gone awry. Looks can be deceiving, but feelings cannot lie. Do I love him? Last night I was uncertain, but this morning, Shrek, thank goodness, there's something I have to tell you.
I heard enough last night.
Oh, you heard what I said?
Yes, every word. Especially who could love such a hideous, ugly beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter to you.
Yeah? Well, you were wrong. Princess, I've brought you a little something.
Fiona! Fiona, 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 Fiona! Whoa, Condoleezza! Princess Fiona?
As promised. Now about my swamp.
Cleared off as agreed. The deed's been put in your name. Now, step aside before I change my mind. Princess, I'm sorry for startling you.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me, for I was just saying a short farewell.
How sweet. But there's no need to waste good manners on the ogre. It's not like it has feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, may I ask your hand in marriage? Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Nothing would make me happier.
Excellent. I'll start the plan to be wed by tomorrow.
No. Why wait till tomorrow? Let's get married tonight, by sunset.
Ooh, anxious, are we? Captain, right ahead. Tell them it's a code red. You're right. The sooner the better. We'll be married by sunset.
Fare thee well, ogre.
Shriek, what are you doing? You're letting her get away. Listen, there's something you don't know. I talked to her last night and,
Yeah, I know you talked to her last night. You two are great pals, aren't you? So why don't you follow her home?
But I want to go home with you.
Look, I told you already. There is no we. There's no us. There's no room for a pathetic, stupid, talking donkey.
But I thought...
Yeah? Well, you thought wrong. I'm gonna build me a wall. I'm talking 10 feet high. See you later, pal. Bye-bye. No one getting in, so don't you even try. A 10-foot wall. Gonna dig me a moat. I'm talking 10 feet deep. Then maybe I'll get some sleep. Piranhas keeping guard, so look before you leap into my moat. Give an inch and they drag me a mile. When I'm out in the world, I'm under attack with the face that launched 1,000 insults. Well, bon voyage, I'm never coming back. Gonna lay myself down, not going nowhere. One room and one easy chair. That's all I ever needed and all that I can bear. Gonna lay myself down. What a fool to think she might love me. I opened my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming, I wanted my home back. How lucky both our wishes came true. Gonna build me a wall, the perfect place to hide. See you later, pal, bye-bye. The best way to conquer, they say, is to divide. Gonna build a wall, gonna dig me a moat, gonna lay myself down. Gonna build a wall.
Listen up, puppet.
We spend our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way, but it's they who need.
way they think, that is.
It's time to stop the hiding. It's time to stand up tall, saying, hey world, I'm different. And here I am, splinters and all. Splinters and all.
Bless your freak.
That's what I'm talking about.
Never take it down, never take it down. Raise your way up high. Let your freak flag fly. Let it fly.
It's hard to be a puppet.
Little puppet boy.
So many strings attached.
Can't cut loose.
But it's not a choice you made.
No, no, no.
Donkey, what are you doing?
I think you of all people recognize a wall when you saw one.
Well, yeah, but the wall's supposed to go around my land, not through it.
It is around your half, you see? That is your half, and this is my half.
Your half?
Yes, my half. See, I helped rescue the princess, so I did half the work. I get half the booty.
Oh, back off.
No, you back off.
Stubborn jackass.
Smelly ogre.
This is my swamp.
There you go again. My. Me. Well, guess what? Now it's time for you to shut up and pay attention. You are mean to me, you insult me, and you don't appreciate anything I do. You're always pushing me around and pushing me away. You're so wrapped up in your layers, onion boy, that you're afraid of your own feelings.
If I treated you so badly, then why did you come back?
Because that's what friends do. They forgive each other.
Oh, go away.
See, there you go doing it again, just like you did to Fiona. And all she did was like you, maybe even love you.
Love me? She said I was a hideous beast, a freak of nature.
She wasn't talking about you. She wasn't talking
about me?
Nope.
No,
I
wait,
ain't saying nothing.
Donkey. No,
you don't want to listen to me, right? Right?
All right, look, I'm sorry, okay? All right, I'm sorry. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre. Can you forgive me?
Oh, what are friends for?
Right, friends.
Friends.
So, what did Fiona say about me?
What are you asking me for? Why don't you just go ask her?
Ask her?
You wanted to be the hero so bad, now's your chance.
But Donkey, the wedding! We'll never make it in time!
Now what kind of Nova Steve would I be if I didn't have a plan?
People of Duloc, we gather here today to bear witness to the union of our new king and queen. And as the warm glow of the setting sun lifts our hearts...
Excuse me, could we just skip to the I do's?
Go on.
Well then, do you, Lord Farquaad, take Princess Fiona?
I do.
And do you, Princess Fiona?
I do.
Oh, okay. Well then, by the power vested in me, I now pronounce...
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
Fiona, I need to talk to you.
It's rude enough being alive when nobody wants you around, but to show up uninvited to a wedding.
So now you want to talk? Well, it's a little too late for that. So if you'll excuse me...
But you can't marry him.
And why not?
Because he's not your true love.
That's outrageous. Fiona, don't listen to him.
What do you know about true love?
Well, I...
Oh, how precious. The ogre's in love with the princess.
That's funny.
Guards, take this abomination out of my sight.
So what do you have to say to me?
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream. If a dream comes true,
awkward.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down a wall and clear a spot for two to be with you.
Are you ready to go, honey?
I can't. Quiet! Outwind Farquaad! Downwind 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 Farquaad!
We've taken your abuse for the last time, Farquaad!
Ew! Filthy wedding crashers! Stop him! Where'd he go?
Well, no more!
It ends today.
Yeah. How dare you freaks interrupt my wedding!
Freaks! Hey! Guess it takes one to know one!
What?
Be prepared to have your mind blown!
Mind blown!
Daddy?
I suppose my invitation got lost in the mail.
Well, if you wouldn't have abandoned me in the woods.
You are 28 and living in my basement.
That's right, people of Duloc. Your leader's a halfling.
Which is a lovely thing to be.
I'm not a little man. I'm a big man. I'm a big man with a castle. I'm a big man with a kingdom.
Oh, bring in the lantern.
Fiona?
I wanted to show you before.
Well, this explains a lot.
She's disgusting! Guards, take her away! What are you doing, you insolent beast? I'll have you drawn and quartered!
Yeah, that's my girl that did that. All hail the dragon!
You were saying, Shrek?
I'm your true love, Fiona.
Yeah, I know. And I'm yours. By night's another. This shall be the norm. Until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form. True form. True form.
Fiona, are you all right?
Well, yes, but I don't understand. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
But you are beautiful. Once upon a time, to look like us would be a pity. But now we know that beautiful ain't always pretty.
I've waited all my life, lived it by the book. Now I know that's not my story. You take me as I am, love me as I look, standing here in all. I'm bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, when I'm with you, I am happy. This is my story.
You laugh at all my jokes. even though they're crude. You don't mind that I'm not classy. We make a perfect pair, radiant and rude. So in love and much too gassy. We are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy. We're a bold and brand new stories to be told. We will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story. And this is how the little ogre came to live on a swamp. With a beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
And his best friend.
And a very handsome puppet.
Okay, that's enough.
And a wig.
Stop.
And a cross-dressing wolf.
No.
What makes us special?
What makes us special?
What makes us special? This is our story.
that our love was only true in fairy tales. Meant for someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me. That's the way it seems. And disappointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. I'm in love. I'm a believer. I couldn't believe it if I tried. What's the use in trying? All you get is pain. When I wanted sunshine, I got rain.
Sorry, I'm late. And then I saw her face.